Well, let's clarify for the audience that, that this fall is, as Aaron said, the lives of these four gentlemen in the community and through the loves of their lives and their, whatever happens, the breakups, the ups and the downs, and it's all very personal.
It's pretty messy.
Yeah.
It's a pretty complicated story in the sense that I'm interested in both the kind of the beautiful moments as well as, you know, frankly, and they quite literally often fall on their faces. For me, a good dinner party is the same as a good story in the sense that it should go wrong. You know, it should. Mm. Everybody should be in the kitchen trying to make it go right. Mm-hmm. And actually, sometimes writing it goes that way too. I've got a lot of people that kind of help out in terms of making sure the stories come together. So,
how much is based? I know some of it is based on your friendships and people you know, but how much of the storyline is based on you?
Oh, I try to blame it on everybody else. But I think that, you know, any group of friends is the same way as a story as a writer, which is that those people aren't just, you know, distinct beings that show up in your life with no purpose. They're parts of you. And so you have the friend who's the sensible one because you need a sensible part of yourself, you know, and you have the friend who's a little more promiscuous because you need to have more adventures. I didn't say that, did I?
No, that's true, but that's very true. And you know what, as you're saying this, I'm thinking about my friendship dynamics, and it's the same.
So it's the same for the story, although I would say the four characters, well, the people have opinions on which one I am, but I would say that they're certainly all aspects of me. So,
writing this story and having it published and everybody reading, I mean, as we saw on the front of the paper, 30,000 readers, and it could be far more than that. Does it put you at a level of spokesperson for the gay community, even across the country at all? And do you ever feel that pressure?
No, I don't feel the pressure, and I don't think I could do it anyway. I think I'd be very poor at it. I think I'm a spokesperson for flawed people everywhere.
we need more spokespeople like you.
I know. I was saying at a reading last night, we were reading from Waterboys last night at a cafe, and I was saying, you know, it's... for me, it's this. My 30s, as well as this series, is about eroticizing the flaw, and so I think that that's. If anybody wants me to come on talk shows talking about how important flaws are, I'm right there.
Oh
so.
We celebrate our flaws every day, don't we?
That's amazing. I want to remember that eroticizing the flaw. That's one of the coolest things.
Sexy
I've ever
way
heard.
To look at it for sure.
Yeah.
Now I'm curious. You're also the head of writing for television, film, and new media at Vancouver Film School. How do your students react to your other moonlighting gig?
That's a really good question. It hasn't really come up yet.
It will now.
It will now, absolutely. it has come up, it just hasn't been talked about, I think. So it's funny because the issues keep showing up, the newspaper keeps showing up on the classroom tables, so they obviously know about it. It comes across in the way I teach. I mean, we talk about TV, I teach TV structure, and this is actually taking from TV, the structure that I use. So that, I mean, it comes across that way. I don't really ever hide anything, and can't really when I'm writing this series.
No.
So, but the nice thing about they're really kind of connected, the series and what I do at the school, which is wonderful. And they both come out of, I just finished my PhD back in May in literature, which was an exercise in masochism and isolation. And I wrote a 300-page document for four people, and I think only two of them actually read it in the end. So, so at the end of that, really wanting to find a community. And the school for me is a community of writers. It's writing is such an isolating thing, to be able to sit around a table with a bunch of other people and just share and read each other's work. It's an extraordinary experience. So that, and then the series, Waterboys, is that same kind of, it's a cheesy word, but communion is the chance to actually kind of just find that place in the world through people and have that sharing. So
I was just gonna ask you what the reason is that you do Waterboys, and is it essentially an elastic band trying to hold people together and sort of connect people, give them a place to feel that they have roots in the world?
Yeah, and actually, you know, the first series, Tidepool Sketches, was even more clearly that. For me, it was a love letter to the city. I felt like I spent more of my kind of 20s in Victoria, where the lesbian community and the gay community were really connected.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And they all went to the same bar, and they all hung out together. And in Vancouver, it's pretty split between the east side and the west side.
Yeah.
And so for me, that whole series was about imagining a Vancouver that didn't exist. It was a place where we all hung out together. Mm-hmm. So it was that elastic effect you're talking about.
Ooh, cool.
Yeah.
So.
Good job.
Nice.
This one's a little different. It's more kind of just trying to. It comes from my family. My family are this Irish, Italian, messy, loud, obnoxious group of people. Mm-hmm. I don't know how I ended up there. I think I was adopted by wolves. And that chance to tell, they all tell stories. They tell tales. I don't actually know what my childhood was about. It's, you know, this complete...
Big fish.
Confabulations. Absolutely. Yeah. Totally. And so it's... For me, finally not denying it in my 30s and just kind of jumping into the story.
Oh.
So.
Good stuff.
Well, that's great. Well,
good work, Robert.
It's a great read and good job. Keep up the good work.
Thanks, guys.
You pick it up now, too. Keep up the reading, Extra West, reading the latest Waterboy story in the newspaper. And as Aaron says, you can pick it up anywhere weekly. And, you know, do yourself a favor or do Rob a favor and leave it on one of his tables in his classroom. Let him know it's being read. We're going to take a break and come back with Darren Parkman. Tell us about the stars.
Woo-hoo.